Hello and welcome to another installation video from NE Joinery. This one we're going to be doing a complete rip out, re-skim, leveling the floors, disconnecting the gas, etc. And then a complete refit of a kitchen. The kitchen is another Kutchehuas kitchen. You will see I've mentioned these in previous videos. They're a German brand, manufactured by Nobilia. Like I say, they're based in Germany. The franchise itself is a, it comes to a Kutchehuas franchise, which is located all over the UK. But I'll flip the camera around so you can see what's happening. Okay, so this is now day three on the kitchen renovation. I'm going to take you inside in a sec just to see where we're up to. Oh, mind the gate. Obviously, we've just been prepping at this stage, so we've got our first fix electrics in, first fix plumbing done. We've obviously bonded some of the channels, which do need building out in a couple of places, so we'll have to go over that again later today. The lads are in there at the minute cleaning up, just hoovering, ready for the latex. So I'm going to flip the camera around and show you what the room looks like. So there you go, you can see some of the channels have been filled in, bonded. As I say, all the first fit electrics have been done now. Hoover's on the go, getting all the floor clean and dust free. And then we'll start the latexing. So now that the floors are the latex, we've got two more coats to put over the top of this just for that finer detailing. All the electrics are in, first fix plumbing's done, and the walls obviously have the skin. So tomorrow, once the latex is dried, we'll be getting the flooring down. We'll include that in the video, and then we'll be on to fitting the kitchen. So today's kitchen delivery day. As you can see, we've got the lads getting the flooring down. We've had a nice early start today to make sure we get this floor from wall to wall at the client's request before the kitchen goes in. The flooring we're using is Quickstep Living Plus Click. This stuff is, as it says, it's quick to get down, it's easy to install, it's scratch resistant, water resistant, and it deals well with a lot of foot traffic, which is ideal for a kitchen space, obviously. Lads are just getting the underlay down now. The underlay comes with the Quickstep brand on it. Obviously, they can guarantee the floor then if you're using their underlay. If you're using this type of flooring in a sunroom, there are different underlays for different purposes of this floor. So if you've got it in a conservatory, you're going to need the heat underlay, which is the same thing but red, with obviously it's heat restricted. But we'll get the rest of this floor down now and then carry on to the kitchen. Okay, so now we've got our first couple of units in. Always important to start from the corner. If you started from this end, by the time you get to that corner, if your corner post isn't set right or you're a couple of mil out, it means ripping them all this back off and starting again from the corner post. Once you've got that corner post set, got your height, you can set your laser level up or spirit levels if you want to use spirit levels. We prefer to use both just because even though the laser is quite accurate, if you split the line, there's, you know, always a 2 mil difference or a mil and a half difference. So it's always important, like I say, set your post, get your corner units in, make sure your units are level, notch out for any wires and bits and pieces at the back or pipe work. But once we've got this corner post in, I'll take you through the next step. Okay, so now the corner post is in, all nice and level. It's always important to check these levels over and over again, horizontal and vertically. So what you've just seen is Ashley planing this end panel to shape. Obviously this wall runs out 5 mil to nothing. So we offered it up, set the margin, hit our scribe line across it, and just planed it to suit. So now we can clamp it in place, pre-drill, and screw these panels together. Okay, so as you can see, we've got a bit of a scribe to do along this. It's obviously it's touching at the top, a bit of a gap, touching, bit of a gap, touching. So what we'll do is make sure this front measurement on our carcass is the same from the front to the carcass. So this, in this case, it's 23 mil. We need it to be 20, so we've only got 3 mil to play with. I mean, usually, you know, you'd get the compass set it to what it needs to be and, you know, score it down there and shave it off. But seeing as it's so small, we can use a pencil this time, so it's not gonna take any off the void there. It'll literally just take it off where it's needed. So you can run that down and it'll leave that pencil mark, which is obviously tracing the shape of the wall. So once we've done that all the way up, we'll then plane it. Just a quick tip, once it's been shaped, just you can see after just there, putting a back bevel on it. This will help that if the wall's slightly out of square, it keep the front edge nice and flush while the back edge sits away from the wall, probably about 2 or 3 more. And that's what it should look like once it's been scribed. Obviously, like I say, we only had 2 mil to play with. These panels come from Kutchehuas, they're cut to size, so any discrepancies in the wall, you're left with minimal amount of play on it. But considering we only had 2 mil, that's tight enough. Once they've got a lick of paint on there, you won't even see it. So as I say, this is my setup now for the male cut. All I've done is use the track saw. The reason I'm using that, it's got a nice flush flat edge there. Can be clamped to the underside so there's no movement. Set it back whatever you need to set it back on. In this case it's 64 millimeters from the gauge to my router cut line. Once I've set all that up, just run it along to make sure that my blade is going to hit the line all the way along that, and now it's ready to cut. So once the routing is done, you'll have your nice male cut there. And again, same principle for the female cut. You're just nipping into that, run the router along, tidy off the edge, and you'll end up with this nice, tight joint. Obviously, again, we've got a biscuit, seal that and clamp it up. But always check it first, dry fitting. So the next video you'll see now, or the next section of this video you'll see, is this bolted together, and we'll start getting the splash back on. Right, so before we connect this worktop up, I'm just going to run through how to mark out the hob cutting again. So we've got a 900 unit. We know half a 900 is 450, so we mark the 450 centre line. We go to our instructions, and we've got, what's that there, 560. So half 560, 280. 280 from your centre line out, 280 from your centre line out. What we tend to do is go for a good edge, or machined edge, or a straight edge, measuring front and back, and then you know that these measurements are going to be square. Again, once you've done that, come back to the instructions, 490 from this cut at the front to the back. It does show that you have to have a minimum of 55 millimeters from the back of the worktop. We've got 60 mil here. We've achieved that by coming, measuring from the front of the worktop to the carcass, and then an extra 10 mil. So our cut here will come 10 mil into this rail. So it'll be hidden behind that rail there. And the front of the hob, so this section here, will sit 10mm in front or 5mm in front there. Okay, so with our female cut now, I'm just going to show you what I mean by routing out for a biscuit joint. So here I have my palm router with the biscuit cutter in the top there. I'll just run that along the face of there, which will make a nice home for the biscuits to sit in. Then they'll get glued up, pushed together, and then left to set. So once routed out, this is what you should be left with. Nice clean cut channel. These packers, which the company have sent to use as biscuits. Sometimes you get timber biscuits. Obviously these are just using plastic. All these are to do is bond each worktop together and keep the top flush. So it doesn't really matter what material these are, as long as they're doing the job. We're going to be using CT1 to bond these together. You can use PVA or any other industrial type adhesive or spec adhesive for whatever worktop you're using. But for this MDF, CT1 is more than adequate. So now that we've got it all glued up and biscuited, it's a nice smooth joint, no lips. Wedge there, so it's pushed it together. Hob cut out with heat reflective tape all the way around. So a bit of a jump forward, but since the last video, obviously we were doing the worktops. We've obviously got the splashbacks on, wall units up, this section around the fridge, sink and dishwasher in. The sink, again, it's the same method as what you're doing for the hob cutout. So cut you out your aperture, put your barrier tape on there, make sure everything's sealed, so no water can ingress into that. But that's pretty much it for this one. If you've got any questions about anything we do, just leave us a message and I'll run through things. But on this one, it was a complete rip out and redo. Brand new floor down. Obviously, we've had to self-level this. There was a 20 mil dip in the middle of the floor to each corner. So we've had to sort that out. Brand new quickstep flooring down with a nice little return feature step here. Dishwasher, sink, boiler housing cupboard, standard wall units there. In this one, we've got the hob extraction hood inside that cupboard there. Just take a look. Obviously, everything's kept nice and neat and hidden away. Got the combi oven and the standard oven there. And coming back round again, nice fridge freezer, housing up and over, and that's pretty much it. So we're almost done here. We've just got a door plate to go in there, bit of tidying up, and then we're finished.